Hare Krishna. Work not to run away from yourself, work to realize yourself. Nowadays, many people are afflicted with what is called workaholism. Just like alcoholism involves a compulsive urge to drink alcohol. So similarly, workaholism involves a compulsive urge to work. Such people just can't stop working. And nowadays, with all of us tuned in through our devices, we don't even have to go to our offices to work. Our work is there with us in our phones and our computers, wherever we are. So now, workaholics, although they are respected in some circles, it's a workaholism is a prestigious addiction. Because somebody who just works so many hours, everybody admires, oh, you work so hard. But what happens? Like all addictions, like alcoholism, where it involves taking in a harmful substance in the body. Now, workaholism involves taking in a harmful mentality into the body. The harmful mentality is to reduce all of life to only one thing, that is work. And then such people neglect their health, they neglect their relationships, they neglect their spiritual side. And such people just get disproportionately obsessed with their work. Krishna talks about this kind of work in the 18th chapter, 25th verse, when he says, Yattu kame psuna, karma sahankare navapunha kriyate bahula yasam tadrajasamudarutam. So he says, Krishna says, Yattu kame psuna, karma kame psuna. Out of great desire to be famous, to have a lot of money, to have a lot of prestige and position and power. Sahankare nava punha, with arrogance. Just see how great I am. No one can work as hard as I can. Kriyate bahula yasam. So kriyate, one who does, performs bahula yasam, means with extreme, excessive endeavor. Tad rajasamudharutam, that is, work in the mode of passion. So this is disproportionate work. And so disproportionate work leads to distress and eventually disaster. So quite often when people become workaholics, it is because they are running away from themselves. They have some grief, they have some frustration, they have some unresolved emotional issues, and they have a spouse whom they don't know how to deal with, they may have kids whom they don't know how to deal with. And you just go to office and work, and in office everything seems to be well organized. You know, there is a provision for everything. And they just do their job and they feel good about themselves. They feel great about themselves. So what has happened here? They are not dealing with their issues, they are running away from those issues. And such work, although it may get prestige and it may lead to performance, it actually doesn't lead to any inner growth. It doesn't lead to any inner realization. Now, we are meant to work for realizing ourselves. Krishna talks in the Bhagavad Gita that how Swakarmanatam Abhyarcha Siddhim Vindati Manava. That if we work in a mood of worship to our Lord, then by that we can attain perfection. And perfection is to realize ourselves as souls, realize ourselves as parts of the whole, parts of Krishna. So, how will we do this? If we work with spiritual consciousness. If we work with an awareness got from studying the Bhagavad Gita, got from spending due time in spiritual activities, got from spiritual association, then that consciousness gets infused within us that we are parts of Krishna. He has placed us in this job and this is our vocation, and we do it in a mood of devotion. So when work is done in this mood, then that work helps us to realize ourselves. We realize ourselves spiritually as souls, we realize ourselves better materially also, because we understand what our strengths are, what our limitations are, what our interests are, and how can we perform in the optimal way. But when we work to run away from ourselves, we just bury ourselves deeper and deeper under the debris of our egoistic achievements. You may say that's like a majestic edifice, but it's not an edifice. It's crushing us underneath. And such workaholics eventually crumble. They have some emotional breakdown, a nervous breakdown. And even if they don't have that, they're spiritually broken down already, because they've neglected and rejected their spiritual side. So by not seeing work as a means to run away from ourselves, but as a means to realize ourselves, then we can do our work diligently, but do it in a way that fosters integration, that brings realization of who we are, that brings lasting satisfaction, not just some fleeting egoistic titillation. Thank you. Hare Krishna.